Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and great to know that you're watching in. We are in the Army Barracks, Column Barracks here in Mullingar, and every week we try to get a video in here and speak to someone who is doing some great work up here. It's a beautiful day once again in Mullingar. We're back in Mullingar because we were in Dublin yesterday and we had an absolute super day in the Epic Museum, and we were on the Jenny Johnson as well. So if anyone wants to go there, folks, check it out, because kids go free June and July. That's to the Epic and to the Jenny Johnson. Okay, we have the 12 bongs, and I have Elizabeth, Isabel, and Lizzie, three girls in the one name with me at the moment. I'm going to start off our show with the 12 bongs. Bong, 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 bong. Isabel, give us a bong.
Bong.
Four. You got four. You're
bong.
Four.
Bong. Bong.
Fantastic. Very professional lady all together here. Bong. 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 And listen, in the background, we have our own bongs bonging away. That's the cathedral here in Mullingar. A fine, beautiful building as well. So I'm just going to set my camera up here a little bit different. Just listen to the beautiful sounds of our cathedral, ladies and gentlemen. Looking forward to seeing you all coming in here, folks. Going to change my camera around because I'm wearing my t-shirt today, and you can't actually see it, but what's written on is it from Mullingar, in Mullingar, the bus sessions, and we'll be going live with the bus sessions later on. And actually, I'm surprised it fits me so well. Izzy, come in here and say hello. Isabel,
hello.
Donnelly, and that's our lady on board today. And Elizabeth, tell us a little bit about yourself. You were the daughter of Helen, who introduced me to you today. So give me a little bit on yourself.
Yeah, hi Ray, thanks so much for having me.
We're delighted to have you on.
Yeah, so I'm working here in Mullingar in Westmead with the Sustainable Energy Communities Network with the SEAI. So as Ray said, my mother Helen was very involved with the program from its inception. There was no nepotism, I promise you. I got in on my own merits in on the program.
She went to college.
I went to college.
She is a doctor.
Oh well, now.
Dr. Isabel.
Anyway.
So tell us a little bit about sustainable energy. You're involved in that in Mullingar and around the area. You're like a mentor to everyone else. Is that correct?
Yeah. So the Sustainable Energy Authority of Ireland have mentors all throughout the country, so there's typically one mentor per county. So I'm your mentor for Westmeath. So we have 14 sustainable energy communities at the moment in Westmeath that I help out and help them get through, we call it the learn, plan, do stage, through their journey to become a more sustainable community. So, but we're always looking for more communities. If anybody's interested, I'd love to help them, chat to them, explain to them the process and what's available.
The area you're covering at the moment, whereabouts are you?
So I'm out in Lismacaffrey.
That's one.
My address is Lismacaffrey, Mullingar, County Westmeath, even though I'm on the border with
Longford.
Didn't
even ask for her number, and then she gave me her address, better still. So tell us, you were, but the other places, like this is sustainable energy spot here in the Column Barracks.
Yeah.
Whereabouts else are you working, and where's the other communities?
Yeah, we have, as I said, we have 14 in total. So we've two in Mullingar. We're very lucky to have two in Mullingar town. So we have the Column Barracks SEC, which have done fantastic work so far, and they're about halfway through their energy master plan. And then we have the Mullingar Sustainable Energy Community, which looks at kind of the wider town, and they have some really good projects coming up at the minute. They're looking at their energy master plan, they're looking at community owned renewable resources, so really, really good group there. So they're the two on Mullingar.
The other thing then, what does it mean then, the sustainable energy? Are we not just being very good at the moment, and are we all doing our bit, and we're throwing all the stuff in the bins, and the right green bins and the wrong green bins and all that? What do we need to do to make it a sustainable energy town?
Yeah, so there's a lot of things we can do, specifically in Mullingar and throughout the country as well. So the first thing we always look at in our sustainable energy is your energy use and how you can be more efficient with your energy use.
Right, so I'm in the house
reduce,
now.
Yeah.
I got up this morning, right, and I put on the immersion, right?
Yeah.
And I forgot to turn off the immersion.
Oh dear.
Right.
That's not a good one. That's a big sin.
Okay.
That's a big sin.
Then I moved down, put on the kettle, and I boiled the kettle four times because I forgot to go back, right?
Yeah.
And we have to burn a lot of energy now.
We are, surely.
Then we go and we leave all the switches on and all the... Does that make a difference?
It does.
So we left on all the switches again. That's burning more energy. And then we walked out of the house and left all the windows open. Then we had to come home, put on the heating again because the house went cold.
Yeah.
Give me more mistakes I'm making in the house. Is it in the car? We go to the car then after that. Right, we go down to the car and we drive down the town and we burn a whole lot of fumes down the town and people get that in their lungs. I could go on forever.
You could.
Tell me about the house again. I'll go back to the house.
Ah, now, come here. I'm not here to criticise anyone.
No, but what I'm saying is, how can someone get involved? And how? What's the basis of what we're talking about? It's very easy. Sustainable energy. Ooh, yes.
Yeah, well, anybody who's interested can join either the Colin Barrack Sustainable Energy Community or the Mullingar Sustainable Energy Community. Or if they're in, we have in Port Laois, like there's housing estate groups that just set up their own sustainable energy community. They just want to focus on their own housing estate. Maybe they have a little creche and a shop, or they want to improve efficiencies there, or they want to do their energy master plan. Energy master plan is a really interesting key part of sustainable energy communities because it'll come into your house and it'll say, okay, Ray, you only have a D1 building energy rating on your house, so you're wasting, you're heating your neighbours and you're heating the front lawn and you're heating the back lawn
it's
and everything.
It's all going out.
So then the sustainable energy community, when it does the energy master plan, it'll come in and say, okay, a house like Ray's, we could get it up to maybe a B1, half your energy bill. Just heat yourself at the right times. You have your smart meters that'll come on for you. You come home at 6 o'clock in the evening, it'll come on for you then. It'll turn off. It'll turn your immersion on and off. Your solar panels heat your immersion, your hot water, and keep it warm for you then for the evening when you want to come home, have a shower. So the Energy Master Plan will identify all those things and give you a good step-by-step guide on how you can get to being a lot more energy efficient without any giving out to you.
Will you give me a few pounds?
Will I give you a few pounds? Well, I personally won't now, Ray, because I don't get paid that well. Sustainable Energy Authority of Ireland give grants.
Right.
So there's grants between 35% and 80%. So depending on social situation. So for a typical four-bed semi-detached home, maybe one person working or two people working, they get the 35% grant for doing all this retrofit. And then someone who maybe not on as good of income or on social welfare or something like that, they can get up to 80%.
But I have to do the job first and then get paid by you or by the sustainable energy board.
The later stage of the energy master plan and the due process in the SEC journey would be where you get a project coordinator to come in. So they go around and they have maybe 10 homes in Mullingar, 20 homes in Mullingar, hopefully as many homes in Mullingar as they can get, and a few businesses, and they put them all together and they work on all them together. So they'll help you then. Yeah, but to answer your question, I'm going around in circles
I can go around circles too.
I get dizzy. But
there is a fund associated.
There is a fund there, yeah. So between, and then 50% up for, say, your community centre, between 30 and 50% for your community centre or for your community organisation building as well to look at it. But a really good aspect of the SEC network is not only you're in a network with other people and learning, but the Energy Master Plan, it's 100% funded for communities, so they can get it's essentially the roadmap of how you can get your community to be a lot more energy efficient and save a lot of money in your local community.
The work you're doing here, like what exactly is the sustainable energy has done here in the Army Barracks, like to give us a sort of an idea of...
Yeah, so there's a fantastic committee here that are working on their energy master plan at the moment. So what they're about halfway through it. So engineers have come in and identified where energy can be saved and where renewable energy can be generated on the site. And they've put the plan together just to make it a little bit more comfortable and energy efficient for the area. So there's some really interesting proposals will come out of that for the area that can feed into the whole plan for the entire
Where'd site. You get the jacket?
The crowd down in Marylandstown, ORS, were very good to me.
Now, you have a piece of paper. What's on this? Is this sort of something you want to share with someone?
Yeah,
or?
So this is, it's just
we
a
can
little...
We can see it. Can you bring it in closer to the camera
it's
there?
Just a little
are we upside down?
On,
we're not upside down.
The,
good.
The SEAI on the actual... It's just a little bit of literature on the programme at all. And if anybody's interested and they think they want to set up their own SEC, if you just go on to the website there...
Oh, brilliant.
There's a function there where you can sign up to the network and then... your details will be passed on to me and I'll reach out to you and we can take the next step if you do want to, if you do want to set up an SEC in your area. And like, we have very real different SEC. Some people just want to, you know, learn beyond the network, get the information and that. Other communities are really ambitious and really, we have a community out in Street and they're really ambitious. They've done their energy master plan and they're planning their upgrades at the minute now. So like, it every community is different. Some just want to learn and others want to get on the ground and do stuff. So we welcome everybody.
You're up and started and running, that's the most important thing.
Exactly,
and
yeah.
We put the word out there and it just, as I say, we create awareness of some shape or form here on the 12 Bong Show. So once again, thank you very, very much for joining us here on the H.
There's no helicopters coming.
We're waiting for a helicopter to come. Did you hear a helicopter last night, no?
No, I didn't, no.
Oh, I thought I heard a helicopter.
You sleep well? I'm conked, so.
So your title is Isabella.
Isabella.
Spelled with I-S-A-B-B-B-E-L-L-A. B-E-L-L-A. And her mother calls her Lizzie.
I know, it's very confusing.
And she was christened Elizabeth. So once again, thank you very, very much. Before you go, I want to do a message with you, but I'm just going to do my show here. And that's the great, great Izzy, Elizabeth, Isabella Donnelly. And she's a great lady. And get in contact with her if you want to get some information. Do you want to give her phone number?
Yeah, no worries.
Give us the phone number there.
087-2915713. And I don't know, can you make out my handwriting there at the bottom?
Yeah, we can see it on the screen.
Yeah.
Brilliant. You're a legend. I'm just going to do this now and we'll just get back to you in 1 minute. We want to thank Claire and Stephen from Granard Buttermarket, who introduced the show this morning. Fair play to yous, and they are legends of people and great fun indeed. Our show comes to you in association with the Collinstown Farmers Market, so big shout out to you guys. They're going live on Sunday, yes indeed. And Kathleen Callahan in Killigordon, County Donegal, it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Kathleen from Mullingar here in the Iron Barracks, Riddle, and happy birthday to you. And we have Heather McDermott, and she's in Naas, and a big shout out to you on your birthday. And we have Aniket, it's a man I met in the airport in India, and we ended up chatting and became friends, and his name is Aniket, and big shout out to you, sir, on your birthday. Olive Clark, she's in Castletown Gagan, a big shout out to you, Olive. And Derek McGee, and he is a road racer. Boom! Yes indeed, I've met him loads of times on his motorbike, but it seems he's gone to Queensland in Australia. So happy birthday to you, sir. Let me see, thank you my dear. Jamie Rennick is there in Navan, a big gentleman, an absolute legend, a big shout out to you. And Aisling Kiernan, she's the painter, not a painter of houses, but a painter of pictures. And she's in Mullingar, and a big shout out to you. And Annie Fitzmaurice, she's in Swords. And we met you in Bundoran many, many years ago. And we've been friends ever since. Don't forget, folks, you'd like to join us on board the bus, which is over here. That's the bus. And if you'd like to join us on board the bus, you are very, very welcome indeed. To promote your business or just simply to tell your story or have the crack with us on the 12 Bongs Show. Farmers Market, don't forget, in Collinstown on Sunday at 11 o'clock. So 11 o'clock, and it's 11 because Sunday is the 11th as well. And a big shout out to our friends who gave me the loan of a bike last week in Green Air. It was an electric bike. I did not mark it, lads. I hope we've done a good video with it. Hopefully they're going to give me another video or another bike next week. Maybe today I'll go down and ask them. And we might do another video for the boys in Green Air. They have electric bikes which are out of this world for everyone in every different walk of life. You won't be walking, you'll be on the bike. Don't forget the Downs GAA Lotto is €7,400. And that will be picked on Monday. What day is today? Today is Friday all day. So go to their Facebook page, get on that lotto, pick a couple of numbers, and you could have yourself 7,400. No matter where you are in the world, it could be in your pocket. Right then, Multifarnham Lotto is going on Sunday, and they're 9,200, so it's a chance of you picking up all that money as well. Go to their Facebook page and write in a couple of numbers and they'll send it to you no matter where you are in the world. Mullingar Harriers are giving away 20,000 euros, ladies and gentlemen, for their all-weather tartan track. And this is going to be world-class tartan track. This means it is top of the class, it'll be all-weather proof. It'll be fantastic for running on. You can actually sleep on it. It's that good. And they're creating 20,000 euros to give to you and a load of other prizes. They have to collect a lot of money as well, but they're selling tickets for 50 euros, so you can divide it out between you and buy a couple of tickets if you want, or just buy one. Our shop local is Mullingar Pewter, always promoting what's good and great about our town. And Facebook page recommendation is Anna Kavanagh, telling us all the news what no one else tells us. A big shout out to you, Anna, and check out her page. Food shout out competition winner is the Annabrook Hotel, and we were down there recently with a load of ladies and they all singing and dancing and having the crack, and it's a great place to go as well if you want to book in and come to Mullingar. We'd like to thank all our friends who've introduced the show this week. We have Bartle and Deirdre from Knights and Conquest in Granard. We have Belinda Hawkins from Forever Living. She was in Granard Butter Market. And special guest Bobby Begley, who was on board especially with good friend Sean, and they're from the Mullingar Harriers, and we had them on board the bus during the week. We had Adrian from Happy Snaps, who was over there somewhere there, and he introduced the show this week. And Leah from Storm in a Teacup. Yes, a great place for ice cream, lads. You could just stay there, you could have a meal, it's like a meal in its own, and you could live in it. You could go in there every day and live on ice cream. Okay, that is in Storm Teacup, directly across from the Joe Dolan statue. What else? Special guest today, Patrick Green. We were up in Epic Museum yesterday, and a fantastic place to go. Great history of our country, and a very visual place that you can interact with all the technology in there as well. And then we went on the Jenny Johnson up and down the river for a while, and great crack. And do you know what? If you're going, head to it. Parking is a little bit sort of dodgy, but you can get parking in one of the hotels on the left-hand side. Just say Ray sent you. And as well as that, children go free July and August. Right, continuing on, Claire and Stephen, once again, thanks for introducing the show, and our superstar as well, who is on show. Let me see, communitycolumbarracksproject.ie. If you want to get involved here, folks, you got to go, and they're putting on webinars, and there's two webinars after going on already this week. So go to that page, community@columbarracksproject.ie, put down your name and they'll send you the link for the Zoom. And don't forget, if you want to fill in the survey is very, very important to keep this barracks for the community of Mullingar. As I say, everything is becoming a community now, and we really have to become a community because things are changing dramatically. What else have we got here? Yes, so go to columbarracksproject.ie and fill in the survey. There'll be hard copies of surveys as well going around, so keep an eye out for them. And once again, to our friends in Epic Museum, that's the Epic, the Irish Emigration Museum, and the Jenny Johnson, once again, thanks guys for the invitation, and we're delighted to be invited up to Dublin yesterday. And you know what, if you want to invite us wherever you are, we will go there too. So once again, from my lady here, is doing an absolute super job, that's Izzy. Thank you very much, or Isabella, and myself, coming to you live here from the Army Barracks. We will chat to you soon. Have a fantastic day, and thanks for being on board. We're going to go on singing with the bus sessions around 5 o'clock as well today. Good afternoon. Bye for now.